Good morning. We will today look at the biography of Henry Vaughan. Henry Vaughan is a metaphysical poet influenced by poets like John Donne, and he is prescribed for the students of BA Part 1 English Literature, Paper 1. Henry Vaughan, biography. The British poet Henry Vaughan, who was born in 1621 and died in 1695, is one of the finest poets of the metaphysical school, who wrote verse marked by mystical intensity, sensitivity to nature, tranquility of tone, and power of wording. Henry Vaughan was born in Brecknockshire, Wales. He and his twin brother, Thomas, received early education in Wales and in 1638 matriculated to Jesus College, Oxford. Unlike his brother, who remained to receive a degree and become a noted philosopher, Henry left Oxford without a degree to pursue a law career in London. At the outbreak of the Civil War in 1642, Vaughan returned to Wales, occupied himself in the law, and then entered military service in the royalist cause. Later in life, he practiced medicine, and he probably studied it during these years. Vaughan apparently began writing poetry in the same decade. In 1646, he published his poems, half of which consisted of a translation of Juvenal's 10th satire. The next year, he wrote the preface to a second volume, Olor Iscanus, meaning the Swan of Usk, which did not appear till 1651. Like the earlier volume, it comprises secular poems and translations and shows little inspiration. In 1648, he seems to have undergone a religious conversion, perhaps connected with the death of a brother that year. The major poetry of Vaughan, all religious in nature, was published in 1650 and 1655 in the two parts of Silex Scintillus, that is Sparkling Flint. Some of the best poems in it are The Morning Watch, The Retreat, Childhood, The Drawing, and Peace. He published more religious verse and prose in his later years, and a number of translations, but nothing after the great volumes of the 1650s retains much interest. He died in Wales on April 23rd, 1695. Vaughan is a poet in whom it is easy to trace the influence of others, particularly the wit of John Donne and the quiet, understated, dramatic technique of George Herbert, to whom he credited his religious conversion. At its weakest, Vaughan's verse is too plainly derivative, and not infrequently, a poem remains valuable today for no more than a stanza or a line. At his best, however, a best that created some of the most beautiful lyrics in English poetry, his voice is profoundly personal, and his ability to maintain the emotional tension of a poem can be impressive. Much of his power derives from a mystical Christian Neoplatonism that he does not share with his poetic masters, and that reveals itself in images of dazzling light, in cosmic visions, and in a fusion of Platonic concepts, such as the descent of man from the sea of light of his childhood to an alienated adulthood expressed in biblical motifs, images, and language. His genius can be suggested by the opening of The World, in which a mystical vision is successfully conveyed in the boldest tone of understatement. I saw eternity the other night, like a great ring of pure and endless light, all calm as it was bright. Henry Vaughan is a metaphysical poet whose work has often been overshadowed by that of the better known George Herbert. Still, Vaughan is an original poet with a fresh, strong voice. Renewed interest. Recently, the 17th century Welsh poet Henry Vaughan has received new attention from scholars for his literary contributions, his strength of voice, and his poetic genius. A jack of all trades, he wrote poetry, was spiritually aware, and practiced medicine. Younger years. Henry Vaughan and his twin brother Thomas were born in 1621 in Wales. His parents were part of the gentry, but many believe that their financial position was precarious, meaning it was uncertain. The twins entered school under the religious guidance of the rector of Langtock, Matthew Herbert. They remained there until 1638, when they were sent to Jesus College, Oxford. In 1640, Henry left Oxford to study law in London, and in 1642, when the First English Civil War broke out, Vaughan left London for Wales, where he accepted a job as secretary to the Chief Justice of the Great Sessions, Sir Marmaduke Lloyd. He stayed there until 1645, and this is where he met and married Catherine Wise. When she died in 1653, she left him with four young children. When the Second English Civil War broke out, Vaughan gave up the law to join the Royalist Army. He struggles to find a voice. Henry Vaughan, a metaphysical and religious poet, was the first to use slant rhyme or half rhyme, words that have similar but not identical sounds. He was influenced by the poet George Herbert. He and Herbert differed. Herbert celebrated the institution of the church, while Vaughan found more in common with the natural world. One of the important things to consider is that Vaughan was aware of Herbert's work, something of an anomaly in that most of the metaphysical poets were unaware of each other. In 1646, he published Poems with the Tenth Satire of Juvenile English, a collection of 13 poems. Vaughan's voice in these poems is aided by the voice of other poets, such as John Donne, who established the metaphysical style. Students, we will learn about the metaphysical style. We did do something about it earlier, later when we study John Donne. His verse is typical of the sons of Ben, who are followers of Ben Jonson. More than half of the poems in the collection are love poems, with Catherine as the subject. His finest work. In his book, Silex Scintillance, published in 1650, we see Vaughan's voice take on new dimensions in the depth of his voice and his use of the scriptures. Vaughan's use of the scripture provides the reader with a clear understanding of the impact of God on Vaughan and the inadequacy he feels about his ability to return the love. With this, we end this lecture on the biography of Henry Vaughan. In the next session, we will look at the poem, The Retreat, which is written by Henry Vaughan. थैंक यू।